Hello friends, welcome back to Anmol's Nail Art. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how I do acrylic extensions at home. So before I start with the video, I just wanted to put this disclaimer up that I am not a trained or licensed technician. So whatever I know, I learned from YouTube, and I also attended a lot of great technicians webinars, etc. So I gathered a lot of information around acrylic extension. That's what I'm going to share with you guys today. So without any further ado, let's begin with our video. As a first step, I'm going to prep my natural nails. So this preparation consists of different steps. I will be showing you one by one. As a first step, I'm using a cuticle remover and I am applying it. I'm going to leave it there like for 5-10 seconds. Then I will be using a cuticle pusher to remove my dead skin from the cuticle area. And another thing, if you notice, my natural nails do not have much dead skin to remove. The reason is because I recently took off my previous extension and I almost did all the cleanup work like a couple of days ago only, so my nail does not require much work here. But still, this is an important step because this will determine, the prep work will determine how long the extension is going to stay on your nails. After removing all the dead skin from your cuticle area, you can use a cotton dipped in surgical alcohol or rubbing alcohol to wipe off your cuticle area and your nail surface. So as you know, rubbing alcohol is a dehydrant, so it will also take off the excess oil that is there on the nail surface. Our next step is to remove the excess shine from the natural nail bed. So for this, I am using this sponge buffer which I got from AliExpress. So this has two different sides. One is a 180 grit side and the other side is a 100 grit side. So the 180 grit side is a little rough than the 100 grit side. So I am using the rough side to take off that excess shine from my natural nails. Another thing I want you to be careful about is don't ever overfile your natural nails. That is one reason sometimes any kind of product, if you put on after damaging your natural nails, it may cause further damage. So always be careful. Now before we move on to the next prep step, I am going to quickly show you how I prep my acrylic extension brush. So today I am using this Cards number 8 acrylic extension brush which I got from AliExpress. So prepping the brush is also an important step for the acrylic extension. I am also using a glass to pour my monomer, and I also have this dropper to take out the monomer from the bottle, and I am using Mia Secrets liquid monomer for my extension. I got the monomer from the Amazon.com website, and I'll be putting all the links in the description box so that you guys can check it out. For the extension purpose, I'll be using 1 to 2 ml of monomer and I'm pouring it into the glass container. After that, I'll be dipping my brush into this and I will be releasing all the air bubbles stuck in the brush bristles, and then I'll be releasing the excess monomer just by tapping the brush onto the sidewalls of my container, and then I'll keep it aside. So the reason we are doing this process is because if there are bubbles stuck in the brush and when you apply the product onto your nails, it may leave air bubbles in the extension, which is not good. So that's why we do the brush preparation. Now let's get back to the nail prep work. So we already removed the dead skin, we already cleaned the excess shine from the nail bed, and we also wiped it with rubbing alcohol. Now I am using a dehydrator to remove any excess oil that is remaining on my nail bed. Please ensure that you are not touching your skin when you apply the dehydrator and the primer. I'm going to apply two layers of primer onto my nails. I'm using Mia Secrets Extra Burn Acid Free Primer. So first I apply one layer and I let it dry completely, and after that I'll be going for the second layer of primer. Also ensure that when you apply the primer, do not let the product touch your skin or the sidewalls of your nails. The primer also helps the extension to last longer because this acts as an adhesive between the natural nail and the acrylic product. I prefer nail forms over nail tips for my extension. So I have these forms I got from AliExpress. This is very comfortable and easy to use forms. This also has that larger wings which I can stick together and I can, you know, make it work in a better way. So before I peel off the form, I always ensure that I'm creating a slight bend at the middle part of the form, and after that I peel it off. I also take that circular cut and I put it at the back side of the foam. So when you do this, what happens, the foam sheet gets a little extra thickness and then you can create a perfect bend at the center and you can, you know, make it work the way you wanted, the whatever nail shape you wanted, you can make it work the way you wanted. It also gives that extra steadiness to the foam. The foam is almost ready to go, so I'm just breaking that tip. Now I'll be placing it under my natural nails. I have a technique here, so when I apply the foam, I look at the center line of the foam and then I center align it with the center side of my nails. So that way I can ensure that the foam is correctly aligned, and then once I'm comfortable with the placement and the alignment, then I press the foam and I make it tighter, and at last I'm going to, you know, stick those flaps to my finger. And also you have to ensure that the foam is straight, it's not towards the left or right, or it shouldn't be pointing upwards or downwards. We need it center aligned and it has to be straight with your natural nails, just the way you are seeing on the screen. It's time for the fun part, and I will be using Glam & Glitz acrylic powder. This is a medium pink color and this is from their Back to Basic collection. So I got it directly from their website, and this is how the powder looks in the bottle. Now it's time for the acrylic laying. So what I did is I picked up a medium size bead and I placed it at the tip of my nails. So once I place it, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my brush and I'm going to move the product from side to side, and once I know that my nails tip is covered correctly, and I'm going to drag it out and I'm going to create that length of my nails. While I'm creating the length, I'm also ensuring that the sidewall of my nail is also getting developed during this process. So I am going to create a coffin kind of nail. So I am ensuring that along with the length, I'm also building that coffin shaped sidewalls, and I'll keep doing it until I get my desired length. I actually don't follow any particular order. I pick small beads and I create the nails, but some people, they go for like 2-bead technique or 3-beads technique and they build the entire nail. But I am a beginner, so I take small beads and I develop that length and, you know, shape of my nails, and then I complete my extension. Now that I have already built up my tip, I am starting with the cuticle. As you can see, I placed a medium sized bead almost at the center of my nail, and then I am gently pushing the product towards my cuticle area. When you do this, ensure that you are not pushing it towards the skin, and do not push the product under the skin. Just ensure that you are just leaving a slight gap between the skin and the product, and then you can just drag off the extra product and you can join the tip and the bead that you just placed, and then you can make it a even shape. Creating the perfect cuticle area and the apex is the most challenging part for almost all the new technicians. So you need a lot of practice. Once you ace it, nobody can literally stop you from creating amazing nail extensions. So I did a lot of practice and I think I almost managed to get it nearly perfect. And I also don't make too thick nails. I ensure that my nails is like credit card thick after filing and shaping and everything. So that's how I do the nails. We are almost done with the extension. So before we move on to the next nails, always ensure that you are looking at the nail from all the sides and ensuring that there is no gap or you do not leave any part, you know, incomplete, etc. Once done, once you are satisfied, you can move on to the next nails and you can start building the rest of the nails. Now that we are almost done with the extension, so I'm having a final look and ensuring that everything is perfect. And after this, immediately what I do is I clean my brush. The reason acrylic self dries, and if there is any leftover, then that bristles get stuck together and then it's gonna ruin the brush. So always right after your extension, dip the brush in the monomer and ensure that you are cleaning it. You are also ensuring that there is no extra product or leftover products on the bristles, and then you clean it, wipe it, and you keep it aside. So this way our brush will last longer, and these brushes are very expensive. Taking care of this is like very important, trust me on this. The next part I'm not going to talk, I want you guys to listen to this. Did you guys hear that? So that's the sound when the acrylic is completely dried, and now you can remove the nail forms and you can start filing. Once you remove the forms from the nails, now it's time for the filing and shaping. For the filing of my nails, I'm using this 150 grit nail file I got from AliExpress, and I'm going to start from the sidewalls of my nails. I'm not going to go too hard, I'm just gently removing whatever excess that I have on the sidewalls, and then I'm also going to shape the tip and I'm giving it a coffin shape. So you can already see that the nail formed that coffin shape. The reason why, because while applying the acrylic, I ensure that I'm bringing that shape, right? So that's why I don't have to really do much filing here. I only did like a slight filing and my shape was already there. Once you are done with the sidewall shaping, now we can move on to the nail surface filing. So I'll be using the same file for the nail surface filing as well. I'm also going to show you how I hold the file. So as you can see on the screen, I'm holding the file like that. Then I'll be moving from one side to the other side in a semi-circular motion, and that way I will be filing off that excess from the nail surface. I'm not too hard, but at the same time I'm applying enough pressure so that the product comes off. Also, I wanted to highlight, for the cuticle area I do not use this file because this is a little rough and it may hurt my cuticle. So I'll be using an e-file to file my cuticle area. Once you are done with the basic filing, I am going to move to the electric file, and I have this file I got from AliExpress, and I'll be using these two kind of bits to complete my filing. So this one I'm going to use all over the surface, and the other one I'll be using specifically for the cuticle area. I am putting the bit onto the drill handle and then I'm going to lock it, and then I'll be starting my e-filing. If you are a beginner with e-files, I don't recommend you to use it directly on your nails. Always try to practice on a practice hand. Once you know how much speed is necessary, how to hold the file, how you can file, once you figure out all these details, then you can start with your own nails, and after that you can start with other people's nail. Otherwise what happens, you will end up hurting other people, and obviously that will not leave a good impression on you, right? So always practice, and then you can use the e-file on your clients or if your friends, whenever you do nails. I use e-file to also shape my sidewalls once again. Any imperfections, I just use my e-file to perfect it. Now I'm going to move on to the cuticle area. So when I do the cuticle area or closer to my skin, always I pull the side skin using my thumb towards outside so that I get that little extra space and I can easily remove the excess from the cuticle side. So our major filing and shaping is almost done. We still have a little more work to do here, but before we move on to the next step, I am going to dust off the dust around my cuticle and the underneath of my nails using this powder brush. This brush again is from AliExpress. I got it like a very long time back. I really love it. It's a very cool looking brush. Even though we did all the filing and shaping and everything, our nail surface is still not shiny, right? So to make it shiny, I'm going to use this same filer which I used in the beginning. So I'm using the 180 side, and I'm going to, you know, file off any unevenness or any rough surface that is there on the nail bed. I'm going to make it even, and after that I'll dust it off and I'll use the 100 grit side to make it shine like a natural nail. Once you are done, all you have to do is use a cotton dipped in the rubbing alcohol and wipe off all the dust and dirt from the top of the nail and from the underneath of the nail, and your nail extension is absolutely ready. So what do you guys think? The very last step for an extension is to apply a nail polish. So I am using Casca's nail polish. I do have a full review video of Casca polishes. I'll put the links in the description box as well as on the screen somewhere so that you guys can check it out. So that's how I do the acrylic extension. So I really wanted to know what you guys think. This is my first video, so there might be some mistakes, but I'll be making more videos, and I really need your honest opinion. So don't forget to subscribe, like, share, all those good things, and also don't forget to leave your comments in the comment section. I really need to know what you guys think about this extension video. So that's it guys for today, and I'll see you soon on my next video. Until then, stay safe, stay happy. Thank you.